Hey guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. So in this video, I'm going to discuss two important schemes that have been approved by the central government recently. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel till now, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with free quizzes as well as the latest updates about the exams. The link of this Telegram group is in description below. And this is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022. Here you will get PDFs, mocks and videos along with mock interviews. Also, we provide you with a booklet that contains all the books mentioned right in front of you. And right now we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you are willing to avail that discount, then you can use RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number that you can use if you have any query related to the exam. So here comes our first question. How many Vandhan Kendras are expected to be established through the Sankalp Se Siddhi Mission Vandhan? So guys, this is the new mission that has been launched by Minister of Tribal Affairs Arjun Munda recently. Now, as far as this mission is concerned, how many Vandhan Vikas Kendras are expected to be launched under this mission? The right answer here is option A, 50,000. Now, you should also know this thing that this mission was launched by the minister when he was inaugurating the new premises of TriFed. So, where is this TriFed located? It is located in New Delhi. Who is the MD of this organization? It is Prabir Krishna. So, these were the facts related to TriFed. Now, TriFed is going to play a major role in this mission. Now, let us discuss what this mission is all about and what is the role of TriFed. Okay, so the first thing that we need to know here is that under this mission, TriFed is going to use different kinds of schemes launched by different ministries and departments, particularly the schemes that have been launched for the benefit of tribal people. Now, these schemes will be used by TriFed in order to increase the pace of implementation of this mission. So that is the first fact and a very basic fact. And I don't expect a question can come on this fact, but that is something that you should know how this scheme is going to work. The next point here is very important because it is stating the targets of this mission. So through this mission, 50,000 Vandhan Kendras, Vikas Kendras, 30,000 Heart Bazaars, 600 Godowns, 200 mini tri-food units, 100 common facility centers, 100 tri-food parks, 100 Sfoorthi clusters, 200 Tribes India retail stores, e-commerce platforms for tri-food and Tribes India brand will be established. So this is very important. So that was all about the Sankalp Se Siddhi mission. Now, when this mission was launched, the Minister of Tribal Affairs, that is Arjun Munda, has also inaugurated 7 more Tribes India outlets. So these Tribes India outlets are located in Jagdalpur, 2 in Jagdalpur, 3 in Ranchi. Remember, both these cities are in Chhattisgarh. And one outlet is in Jamshedpur and one is at Sarnath. Now guys, this Sarnath is a very famous ASI, that is Archaeological Survey of India's heritage site. So this is the first successful collaboration with the Ministry of Culture where this Tribes India outlet has been established. Now with these outlets, with the launch of these outlets, the Tribes India outlets in India, the total number of Tribes India outlets in India is 141. So that is an important number, guys. A question can be framed on this as well. Now, as far as the NABARD students are concerned, guys, please cover this mission thoroughly because this is important for your examination. Even though RBI and SEBI students can also expect a question on this mission, but for NABARD students, there is a higher probability that a question on this mission can come in your examination. So here comes our second question. How many components are there in the Deep Ocean mission? 6, 10, 5, 4, 3. Out of these 5 options, the right answer here is option A, 6. Now, what is this Deep Ocean mission? Many of you must have heard about this Deep Ocean mission earlier as well, because this mission was announced in the year 2020 only, and right now this mission has got approval from the cabinet committee. That is why it is in the news. As far as the details of this mission are concerned, then you should also know this thing that back in the year 2020, there were not many details released by the government, but right now we have plenty of details to know about this Deep Ocean mission. So let us discuss this mission in detail now. So the first component is development of technologies for deep sea mining and manned submersible vehicle. So here we have two keywords in the first components itself, and if you understand these keywords well, then the entire component will be comprehensible to you. So first of all, the thing here is that these technologies are expected to be developed indigenously. The second thing here is that these technologies are going to be developed for deep sea mining. So the first component of this deep ocean mission is going to focus on sea mining. And what is this that we are going to mine in the ocean seabed? The mining will be done for polymetallic nodules. And these nodules contain a precious amount of minerals and metals. So that is going to be explored through this component. Now, what is the technology? What is the thing that is going to explore this thing? Basically, we need a machine. We need the technology to explore minerals, to do mining. So that vehicle, that machine would be the manned submersible vehicle. So this vehicle is expected to go down to 6,000 meters in the ocean, which is very near to the seabed. And this vehicle will carry 3 people with itself. So this vehicle is going to be used for the sea mining. Now guys, remember that if we are going to do sea mining, we need to be careful about it being sustainable. We cannot destroy the ecological, geological and the environmental atmosphere of the oceans. Therefore, in order to keep those things healthy, in order to keep those things intact, we need a sustainable guidelines for commercial mining. So basically, if this exploration is successful, then only we can do the commercial mining in the ocean seabed. But commercial mining cannot be done carelessly. Therefore, this International Seabed Authority of the United Nations will develop a code, a guideline for the sea mining. But until or unless these guidelines are released, we cannot do the commercial mining in the seabed. And until this mission is successful, until the exploration is successful, we cannot do this commercial sea mining anyways. Okay, now the mining will be done for polymetallic nodules in the Central Indian Ocean. So this is the area you should remember. So that was all about this first component. Sea mining is the deep sea mining is the focus, and this deep sea mining will be done through this manned submersible vehicle. And deep sea mining is going to pave the way for commercial sea mining, and that commercial sea mining cannot be done until we have a sustainable code in place. And that code will be developed by this International Seabed Authority of the United Nations. So I hope that this much is clear to you guys. Now I am moving on to the second component, that is development of ocean climate change advisory services. So through the mission, technology will be developed to provide weather forecast for the ocean and surrounding areas on seasonal to decadal timescales. Because you would know that oceans play a major role in deciding the weather of the coastal areas. So it is very important to understand the entire weather of the oceans. The third component is technological innovations for exploration and conservation of deep sea biodiversity. So under this component, the new species of flora and fauna will be discovered, as well as their conservation will be the focus of this component. The next component is deep sea ocean survey and exploration. So here, the potential sites of multi-metal hydrothermal sulfides mineralization will be explored and identified. So this is, you can say, another mineral along with the nodules that will be explored under this deep ocean mission. The fifth component is energy and fresh water from the ocean. So this component will focus on developing technologies for offshore ocean thermal energy conversion powered desalination plant. So what is the purpose of this entire technology, offshore ocean thermal energy conversion powered desalination plant? This is going to obtain electricity from the ocean as well as fresh water from the ocean by reducing their salination. So desalination is to reduce the salinity of the ocean water. The next component is advanced marine station for ocean biology. So this is under this component, basically the humans will be trained in the field of ocean sciences. So this component particularly aims to train the people in India in the field of ocean sciences so that we can have an expert team working in the field of this particular ocean science, where the minerals is also there, mining is also there, and we are exploring the different kind of industrial opportunities from the ocean, as well as keeping the entire environment and the ecological ecosystem of the ocean intact. So that is all about this deep ocean mission. I hope that you have understood it well, and in case you have any query, then you can ask me in the comment section below. So this is our next question. Which of the following is untrue about the India Interagency Expert Committee on Malaria and Climate? Option A, it has been launched by IMD, ICMR and Malaria No More. Option B, it will explore and advance climate-based solutions for accelerating the elimination of the vector-borne diseases from the country. India aims to eliminate malaria by 2030. IMD will be providing weather data for issuing malaria forecast. The IEC will receive technical assistance from WHO. So out of these options, I know that majority of you are guessing that option C would be the wrong answer here, because it does not have anything to do with this inter-agency expert committee. But let me correct you, my friends. The right answer here is option E, because this is the wrong statement here. All these statements are very well connected to this inter-agency committee. Now let me tell you what this committee is all about. So this India Inter-Agency Committee has been set up on malaria and climate by IMD, India Meteorological Department, ICMR, Indian Council on Medical Research, and Malaria No More, which is an NGO. So these three organizations have partnered to launch this India Interagency Expert Committee on Malaria and Climate. Now, you would know this thing that malaria is a vector-borne disease and climate plays a major role in the spread of vector-borne diseases. Therefore, this interagency group, this India Interagency Committee on Malaria and Climate, is going to study the climate and the spread of diseases, particularly malaria. So how can the climate-based solution can be developed so that the spread of malaria can be contained? That is the terms of reference for this committee. That is the basic function of this committee, that is to develop solutions so that the malaria can be eliminated by 2030. So that is the whole purpose of this group. I hope that this is clear to you. Guys, my question from you is that, can you tell me where is this NGO located in India? So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. Which state has launched Yuva Shakti Corona Mukti Abhiyan to create awareness about the COVID pandemic? So Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh are in the options, out of which Madhya Pradesh is the right answer. So this Yuva Shakti Corona Mukti Abhiyan is going to create awareness among the students as well as the teachers of basically colleges or university. So this awareness is related to following the COVID-19 behavior. So that is the whole purpose of launching this mission. Next question is, the GI certificate Jalgaon Bananas belong to which state? Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Maharashtra, Punjab, Gujarat. Out of this, Maharashtra is the right answer. Jalgaon is a district in Maharashtra. So these bananas are grown there. Now remember, these bananas got their GI certification in 2016. Why is it in the news then? The reason behind this is that these were exported to Dubai recently. Now many GI certified agricultural produce are being exported to different countries. Your responsibility is to keep a track on those different boards and their GI certification, from which state or which place do these products belong. And you have to tell me that which state does this Qatarni rice GI certified product belong to. So this is your task for today. Tell me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this session.